Ladies and gentlemen, here they come with the flag. Let's let them hear it. A round of applause as they bring all glory down to kick off our DMV Vendetti Memorial.
Outside of Bonnie, out of Cumberland, Rhode Island, and the BJ McMahon Trucking Honda Auto Supply for 7, that's Wayne Newman. Bobby Cullen Jr. starts next, he's out of Princeton, Rhode Island, and the Bell's recycling number 12, outside of Bonnie. Green is underway, the field rounds up with Kenny Morissette, the Bonnie Sprint number 98, Doug Marlowe, the Mountain Dad number 56, Rayleigh and Steve Sanford.
Trying to hold on to that outside lane, works the outside in that third spot of Dave Bergman right behind him. Larry Gelinas in the M80 trying to work his way into a qualifying spot. He came a long way. Scott Romain does not want to go home empty-handed. A good jump on the outside as Bergman gets a little sideways. That puts Cavallaro up to third. Gelinas fifth, 0-6. Right now, the top of the bubble is Mike Hassel, and we've got a spin. Zingali goes around off the fourth corner. That's going to bring us out in the room for a squash.
Make it at all. We'll see who can make it in. Right now it's Matt Dewey and Rob Morey on the pole. Dewey running, completing his first season, not a full season, had some problems. But he is here. Rob Morey making his first start in a pro stock here at Seekonk Speedway. Green flag is back out. We're back on the way. And Dewey's trying to get it over. Right now, Rob Morey outside. We're going to hold on to that second spot. Cavallaro, third, Bergman, and the 80s. Linus. Look at Dion going three high. Gets forced to the outside. You can see the 7, X, get a little slightly. Deion Graceful loses a bunch of positions. And get here, makes it 3 wide. The 7, the 15 loses the right rear tire. He's on the rim. And that's going to be a tough break from Mike Hassel. And that's going to bring us under another quad.
So Mike got a little squirrel coming out of ball there. Deion looks like his right rear tire has gone flat, as you have said before. It looks like Wayne Deion is okay, though, as he slowed early on after that incident.
Well, he slowed up. He was running 8th on the field, but that caution may put him back. We'll find out whether the scorers will put him back in his running order.
6X pro stock this weekend. Now, Rob, looking at mobile, we should be going back to green this time. Bye.
Well, once again, Dewey and Murray bringing him down. Cavallaro up to third. Now Bergman in fourth and Delane in fifth. Green flag is out. We're back underway. And Dewey is going to have to jump and go right ahead. Murray is front line, but Murray hasn't given up yet on the outside. On the back straightaway, they go. Murray trying to get a jump. Got a little bit of an edge through the corners, but nothing there.
Morrow has a left rear tire. He loops it right near the stop finish line. This will bring out yet another yellow in this Pro Stock B main. Oh, we have trouble back then. They're all getting on the blindness. Your hand. This car is 56 though, down at Seekonk today. We should be getting green this time by as Dewey and Murray bring them out. This is 3 out of 4.
Well, 5 laps complete, 15 to go. Looks like Mike Castle's ready to rejoin the field at the rim. And green is up, we're back underway. That question is what Castle needed as he's back out and racing. Dewey with a great jump out front. Takes over the lead. Murray back to third, and Bergman sticks his nose in there. Ah, from the outside, Jolinas following from the inside. And Dave Sylvia right in bobbing a hand to number 50, looking to qualify. This is the AV Memorial. Boy, I'm going to have to open shot. You can see a bunch of smoke billowing out of the back of Mike Castle, number 15. Taking evasive action through the infield, but Wayne Newman is the number 7. A right hand, and bobbing again, and Dave Sylvia coming down for the course can also get
here at Seekonk Speedway. They got that car ready to run his heat event. Unfortunately, he was just missed qualifying, but he is back up and sitting third on the field. That is a qualified spot. Looking for the green this time by Elrod. Like what he sees, we're back underway. Bergman on the high side, looks like he's got the lead all to himself. Dewey back to second. Battle for third between Murray and Jolinas. Holden fifth, Francisco Caro. Cavallaro sits sixth, but falling just a little bit back as Holden gets by and to zero. Tries to get underneath with Lenny Ellis right behind. Well, that's a tough break for those three competitors all in a qualified spot. Mike Cavallaro with absolutely nowhere to go trying to avoid Rob Murray as Rob went around.
Coming out of fall, the green is John Bergman gets a good jump on Murray. He's looking in. You see Bobby Anderson has problems with that piece on his number 50 guard. It's starting to rip away. So White has fade back just a little as Storm and Norman Holden gets a good run through 3 and out of 4. On the NA,
Holden knows his track just as well as anybody else. He's a three-time track champion, 1983, 84, 85. Currently running third on the outside of Jolinas, looking for that bump. Jolinas battling Dan Bumper.
Right now, the battle for the last qualifying position is between the 99, the 50, and the 12. They all want it. Only one of them will get it.
Right now, Deion Hand running 60 and 7 on the field. One car out, Bobby Pellin. He's one car out of qualifying to the big 100-lap open competition event. Right now, Bergman leads up down. Dewey, Jolinas, Ellis, and Holden, your top 5 cars. Deion Hand, Deion a little bit slow on the outside. He's lost a couple positions. He's in danger of losing that spot.
Bobby Pellin has got that car underneath Bobby Hand right now. He's looking to see the way to run a qualifying spot. Bobby Hand. In turn two.
Well, looks like he may have had some help from the 27. They made contact going into the corner. And a tough break tomorrow. He's run around a couple of times today. And 14 laps down, 6 remain, 7 are qualified for the 28 car, 100 lap open competition event. Bergman and Dewey going to bring them down this time. Jolinas, Ellis, your second row. Alrod likes what he sees. Green is out, and what a jump Bergman gets. Jolinas all over the back. They go. Bergman's all along out front. Jolinas runs in second. Dewey back to third, but here comes Storm and Norman on the inside.
Watch Bobby Pellin, that number 12 guy. He's got that car working out on the low teams right now. Trying to get into the top 5, and it looks like Pellin will do so. He is now underneath the 02 of Dewey. Bobby Pellin having a very, very strong run right now in the number 12 guy.
Danny Gamache trying to get on the inside, Bobby Gahan right behind him, and Dewey gets slideways off the corner, holds it, but that puts a 27 into him as Gamache has nowhere to go. Dewey was sideways off the corner, trying to direct it. him in the 27 of Danny Gamache Tangle, and Gamache is not happy with that. Danny climbing out of his car, having a couple of words with the driver of the 02 and walking back into the pit area. Tough, tough break as Dehan, the 27 of Gamache, had just worked his way into a qualifying spot when Matt Dewey, yesterday before his heat, went out, finished, I believe, ninth in his heat, and now runs second in the consolation event. So he does not have many laps on this one-third mile oval. Looking for a green this time by Al Rodriguez. Looking for the lights, what he sees. We are back underway. A good jump by Brendan on the outside. Right on his back bumper, but Jelinas on the outside. Trying to hold on to that second spot, but I don't know. It's going to be a tough one. Holden knows this track as well as anybody.
And hung up to the high side of number 12. DeHaan working his way into the top line. Wayne Dion sits on the bubble. There are two to go this time by.
Well, DeHaan's had some success here in the past. He's won a couple of these in the last race. And he's come down. If he makes it today, he's going to have his work cut out for him. Jelinas on the outside, sliding back, sits fourth. DeHaan on the inside. This time by, it's one lap remaining. Jelinas and Gahan, your top five. Pellin and Dion, sixth and seventh out of turn number four, and that's how they're going to be. It's going to be Bergman, Holden, Ellis, and 80 of Larry Jelinas, fourth. Fifth will be the 50 of Bobby Gahan, sixth. Bobby Pellin and Wayne Dion rounding out the top seven qualifiers. Matt Dewey just missing it out by one position.
Those cars will advance to the Pro Stock 100 lap open competition race later on this evening. Coming out next to the speedway will be the Mighty Midgets for their qualifying heats. And here to take you.
That number two is the machine that Paul Presto drove a number of times. There was one that sold the car. He's moving out of the area. And Rudy Bonacher has brought it to run ARDC in NEMA next year. First heat lined up, ready to go. A quick 10 laps coming at you. Mike Lugel and Matt O'Brien on the grid. Mike Lugel pushes badly in turn two, and Rush Moore comes all the way through the fifth spot to take the lead.
Event today. Steve Dumas gives him the signal to cross him up. Dick Williams on the pole. John Farrell to the outside. Barry Cannon and Paul Wallace make up row number two. Nick Fenaro and Joe Payne Jr., two TQ graduates, make up row number three. Keep an eye on that row number three. The defending NEMA champion, Drew Fernando in the M&H tire, number 45, sits in the fourth row. Here we go, coming up, tire number four. Coming down the front straightaway, Dick Williams has the early advantage, but look at Paul Wallace on the outside. Wallace using the Volkswagen groove, sticking that number six up on the outside. Barry Cannon in the Porsche automobile comes to second. He gets taken by the number three of Joe Payne Jr., the super modified driver, moving to the outside of Paul Wallace, coming off of turn number two. He's using the high side, dives down at the turn number three. He's got second spot, looking for Dick Williams. Comes around the outside of Dickie Williams, going into turn number one. A big battle now for the fourth, fifth, and sixth spots between Nick Fenoro, Bob Ciccone, Barry Cannon, and Drew Fenoro. Paul Wallace now into the mix. We got cars scrambling down the front straightaway, going into the corner for the fourth spot. Paul Wallace has got the advantage over Noki Fenoro. Fenoro hanging it on the outside, works past Wallace, coming off the turn of the four. Bob Ciccone also driving the Mike Roselli number eight, coming off turn number two. He's looking to the high side of Wallace. Wallace trying to hang in there. Only six cars are going to qualify. Halfway point. Halfway to go in this e-race event. Look at Nicky Fenoro charging to the front in a hurry. He's trying to go past Dickie Williams on the outside. Makes it past on the outside. Going into turn number three. He takes the third spot. Dick Williams right there hanging on. He rides in a fourth spot. Bob Ciccone challenging Williams coming off turn number two. Using that outside, diving down at the turn number three. Williams back on the bottom, cannot make it stick. He will get moved back to the fifth spot. The man on the bubble right now is the number six of Paul Wallace. He's got the Tech Automotive number 25 of Barry Cannon right behind him. The Porsche motor running very, very well for Barry Cannon. Two laps to go, popsicle sticks are in the air for Joe Payne Jr. out of Hawthorne, New Jersey. He's got a commanding lead over Drew Fenoro, Nick Fenoro Jr., Bob Ciccone, and Nick Williams' white flag is out. Coming off turn number four, checkered flag's gonna fly for the Miller Contract and DEF Alarm Systems. Number three for Joey Payne. Second is six-time NEMA champion Drew Fenoro. Third will be Nick Fenoro Jr., followed by Bob Ciccone, Dick Williams, Paul Wallace, Barry Cannon, Lee Smith, and John Farrell. Right down to Thompson each year, every year it comes right down to it, the final race of the season. A lot of competitive cars between the Northeast Midget Association. Steve Dumas gives him the signal to double them up the next time by. When the cars hit the stripe, we're going green.
Mike Ova and John Payne will bring them down. Two rookies, although John Payne has a lot of TQ experience, and Mike Ova has lots of football. John Payne slingshots away from the outside as Mike Ova shoots that little puddle, getting that old up to speed, and he's getting run over by Volkswagen. John Payne, oh boy, in the Fontana. That's not a Volkswagen, that's a Fontana moving into second spot. Payne, Coy, Paul Scally in the 30, and here comes Bob Seymour, higher on the outside. He's in fourth now, looking for third, and he's got it off the back stretch. Chuck Wellings in fifth spot, and Brian Cleveland in sixth spot, and he's got Brian Kovalak and Big Shaw coming at him.
And Brian Cleveland is on the bubble. He is your sixth place qualifying. He's sitting in the sixth place qualifying spot. He's got Brian Kovalak and Big Shaw up over his back bubble. Kovalak is on the lead. Shaw goes around the top, three wide, going into turn number one.
Meanwhile, up front, Joey Coy has taken the lead, but he may not have it for long. And Mark Seymour working on the outside. Coy on the inside, Seymour on the outside. One and two, down the back stretch, through three and four, once again, Seymour. And John Bayer's toenail comes across the line with the lead. Seymour is rarely handling. Those targets don't have all that much power, but this is a handling track. And if you can keep the car handling, you can go well here. Coy in second, John Payne holding down a comfortable third, Paul Scally in fourth, and Ryan Kovalov has come through into fifth, Chuck Welling in sixth, but he may lose that to a fifth round. Here's Shaw, and Shaw does get him going into turn one. That's just on sixth.
The white flag is going to fly, coming off turn number four, Bobby Seymour, he's going to be in the 1987 amateur. He's got Joey Coy right behind him, about a straightaway behind him. Here he comes, coming off a turn number four, checkered flag flies, coming in the Arati, number four of Bob Seymour. Second is the Sunoco Race Fuels, number 94 of Joey Coy, followed by TQ graduate John Payne.
We'll see in a little while.
It's the Dwyer brothers in lap number 20, sponsor of the number 20 sportsman car, that's the Skip Around Limousine Incorporated. Lap number 21, that's in memory of Scotty T. Lap number 22, Pittsburgh Paints and Jim Sylvia, the number 116 once again. Lap number 23, Graves Berlacki Speed Equipment, proud supplier here at Seekonk Speedway each and every week. Lap 24 and the final lap, 25, brought to you by Daytime Engineering.
Well, we go into green flag racing momentarily. But right now, if you have your program with you, you should look in to see if you have tonight's lucky sticker, the fall leaf. If you do, you'll have to report to the base of the tower at the program booth. All programs are sold out, so if you have a program, look in to see if you have the lucky sticker, which is a fall leaf, and I'll be running down the gifts momentarily. The green is out, we're off to racing action.
We're parking the outside, looking for the jump, overturning, determining, hold on down low. Side by side out of that first corner, Clark on the high side, and that number 31 trying to get going, but the Camaro down low. Got an advantage, and he's going to, who's going to take our money? It's going to be, I think, great job by Turpin, leading lap 1 o'clock. No, slideways, off that second corner, gathers it back up, not before Mealy can get underneath the 65 of oil for that third spot.
Watch Rusty Bryant, he's trying to make his way through the back. Right now, him and Stacy Holmes with the 16 on neck and neck. Your leader is still the 14 of Turpin.
Turpin leading another lap. Clark, Mealy, Randy, and Laurie is on time. Look at me, brother. Going three wide through the field right now.
Oh, we have trouble on two as Mealy gets into the 31. Oh, it's, oh, Rhoda hits the wall real hard on the backstretch.
And Jim Sylvia off the corner with nowhere to go, hard into the passenger side of the 31 of Clark. That is a tough, tough hit. You can see the wheel off the left rear. The right rear on that number 31 still way down on the track. Track crew quick on the scene to check on these three drivers and see if they're all right.
You can see Pete Rhoda moving around his number 41. The Silver Brothers towing crew ran right over to the 31, and Sylvia sits in his 116. I can see him. They are calling the ambulance to the 31 car.
Well, that's going to bring us.
We have a red flag incident here, folks. Please stay back from the fence area.
Clark, of course, was
Wallace. And they're available down at the base of the tower, along with a gift certificate from the Grease Monkey, located on Route 6 in Seekonk. Turpinning is your leader. Lopes is to the out. Is it Lopes?
Ernie Boucher to the announcer's tower, please. Ernie Boucher to the announcer's tower. Green flag is out. We're underway. Fernandy's trying to get a jump. Went to shift the car. Slide, switch just a little bit. That gave Turpinning the front spot. Here comes Fernandy's once again. And look on the third group. Rusty Bryant started 10th on the restart, and he is going three wide around the field.
Well, they're going to make it four wide there, Kevin. Rusty's going to get out of danger quick, and he is able to. He is on the move with that number 08 street stock. Watch him on the outside as he is going to the front in a hurry.
O'Brien up to 6th spot, but Turpinning still out front. Lauro on his back bumper, the 26 of Fernandy's inning. Kirby out on that number 96. Since going down the field, Tatro trying to go out of the band. He's moving up to Sportsman's in 97.
Well, Lauro giving heavy pressure to Turpinning in the 14 right now. Spacchiasso right there. Fernandy's hung on the outside with Tatro. Rusty Bryant now on the side of Lauro in the number 38. Rusty will be battling for position momentarily. McQuaid trying to make a move under Tetro in the number 45 right now. Your leader is still Turpinning in the 14.
Well, so far, the car who's made the biggest move, Bobby Vancourt Jr. And that junior's on his line number 21, started way back in the field, started 19th, and he's sitting 7th on the field. He's been able to move through traffic very well.
Well, one thing for Turpinning right now, he's sure picking up a bunch of extra money as he's picking off all the laps right now, and that's helping him out for a good payday.
Well, it's $25 a lap, started on lap 1, and all the way through to where we are now. Looks like the 08 of Bryant slipping just a little on the outside as Moulton makes it three wide between the 46 of Rotundo and the 84 of Radcliffe.
Your leader is still Turpinning, being pressured heavily from the 65. Sparky has brought his number 96 up to third. He's on the bumper of Morrow. McQuaid on the bumper of Arsenal. Morrow on the bumper of McQuaid. Boy, is action tight in this street side feature.
Side by side, wheel to wheel, bumper to bumper, all the way through. And look at Laurel, give a little tap to Turpinning off the corner. That's letting him know he's there. That is not rough. side by side, bumper to bumper, racing all the way through the field. Lauro all over the back of Germany, looking high, low, or otherwise trying to get through. Lauro again, trying the low side, but nothing there. Fernandes falling back in the high side. Morrow looking to the high side of McQueen, this time through 3 and 4.
Rusty Bryant definitely has a problem with that 08 as he was led back in the field right now. Your leader is still the 14 of Germany, being heavily pressured from the 65 of Morrow. Sparky holds on to third. Morrow's making a run into the fourth position. Halfway this time by. We are halfway.
Interpreting slideway with around the corner. Pesto hit in Lauro. Sparky made most of it. He went to the outside of Lauro through 3 and 4. Lauro right behind him trying to get through, and here comes the 21 of Bedford.
Well, Sparky tired of waiting on the bottom. He's trying to bring his number 96 Camaro up on the outside. He's got it working. Can he get past Lauro? Looks like he has Lauro taking Camaro, but maybe not.
Oh, they get together. That opens up the door for Sparky. Here comes Arsenal.
Germany trying to hold on down low, slideways off the corner, but that gives a lead to Sparky. Sparky leading his first lap and picking up a 25 allocation from that last sponsor. Morrow on the high side, the number 38 following suit, but look at Sparky trying to pull away from the rest of the field.
Yeah, you can see Rusty's having a very, very bad handling problem in that 08. This is the Inclusive Championship. I'm sure you can still at least have a little smile on his face.
But the new leader is Sparky, though.
Well, what it looks like on Bryant, the left rear quarter panel is banged in. It looks like that's into the tire, and that's going to cause a problem for that 08. And he is still on the field in danger of going a lap down. Arsenal went Morrow all over the back bumper in second. Third, it's Germany. Fourth, McQueen. Lauro fifth. Lauro slideways on the corner. That's going to put Betancourt down low.
James Lawrence bringing the 02 car off. The 2 car championship now, Matt Dewey. He is into the top 10 right now in the 02 car, which is for sale.
Your leader is still Sparky Arsenal. Now he has heavy pressure from the 38 TCI Press Cox Communications. Number 38 Camaro Chief Morrow. Germany is still sitting in third. Rusty Bryant bringing his car into the fifth along with Fernandes. Your track champion pulling in early in this street stock feature. Sparky Arsenal, still your leader.
Well, not the way you want to end your season. After winning the championship but going out without a win. This time by, 5 to go for Sparky Austin on that number 96. Looking for his second win of 1996. Morrow all over the back number, looking high, low or otherwise. Trying to get by Sparky all over, holding his groove, not letting him by.
Real strong run from Sparky Osmo and Keith Morrow today. Those two come out. You can see the first 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, about 10, 12, 14 cars of Camaros. All Camaros up front. Sparky's still your leader. 3 to go for the 96 Camaro, Sparky Osmo. This time by 2 to go.
Well, Morrow trying to get some momentum going on the outside off of turn number 4. Looking low off the corner, but Sparky slamming the door, giving him a little bump. Letting him know he's there for 1 and 2. 2 laps to go. Morrow looking high, low, or otherwise. Trying to take down that front spot. Sparky Osmo is your leader through turns 3 and 4. This time by, it's the white flag. Look at Morrow looking low. White flag is up. And oh, they touch. Everybody keeps their spot. 1 and 2. Morrow is all over the back of Arsenal. Arsenal all over the track. Trying to hold on a lead out of turns 3 and 4. Checkered flag is waving. Morrow looking low. Sparky shuts the door and takes down the win. It's Morrow second. Tiffany McRae, Bedford is top 5. 6 through 10, it's Morrow. The 02 of Lawrence, the 60 of Moulton, Radcliffe, and the 33 of Sean Sylvia. But taking down the win. And a bunch of extra lap money. Out of Attleboro, Mass. And the Pelletier Excavating, number 96. Give it up for Sparky Arsenal.
Sparky Osmond, former big-time winner of the Formula 4 division, driving that famous number 0 Rabbit. Made his move to Chief Rocky Aragon. He pulled off his second win in 1996 to the number 96 Camaro. It's Sparky Osmond taking his victory lap. This time by, coming up next, it's the feature time for the legends.
Connecticut. Then the pit starting spot, the 75 of Justin Mann aboard the performance cycle engine machine from Plainville, Connecticut. In the fourth spot, driving the 00, Peter Valeri, Valeri construction machine out of Warren, Massachusetts. Then the third spot, the 99 New York, Byron Chu, out of Buzz Chu Chevrolet Holden Ford, Brandon Moon from East Hampton, New York. The second spot, on the outside, the 10X of Grand Gun Basie, all the interior machine from Plainville, New York. Then we have the 83, Joseph Warrior, on the point from Matapoyce, Mass, in the independent repair service. Looking for, yeah, nice long jump, throw the green flag, pop up turning board, we're doing what we're going to do for a race against Seekonk. And then the 76X Jags Palmer, Metaport construction machine from Berlin, Connecticut, followed by the 83 of Joseph Warrior, the point is all the way back to the fifth, half of the right. Picks up that fourth spot, side by side from fifth, sixth, and seventh. Harrison, Bruce Harrison, that number two, making that high groove work around the 00 of Pete Valeri across turns three and four. Now Harrison making a move way high, almost tags the wall, getting around Joseph Warrior down the front straightaway. Harrison from Harrison Motorsports up in New Hampshire making the high groove of Seekonk work. It's a long way around, and he's getting the job done. Right now, put the moves on David Casey from all his mass. And number 31, he's trying to reel in and going down into turn number one. Now he has to fend off the challenges of the 15X machine of John Bagshaw. Bagshaw holding him off as that high line is not working too well for Harrison at this point. At the stretch, out into turn number one with a six-car lead. It's the 99 of Byron Chu. Chu is chewing up this Seekonk Speedway here. But a Buzz Chevrolet Oldsmobile Incorporated sponsored car from East Hampton, New York. He's a semi-pro, and he is definitely looking good here at the Godfrey Palace in Seekonk today. Yeah, the 51st anniversary of Seekonk Speedway, the DAV Fall Memorial event here for the New England Legends Tour. Ladies and gentlemen, single file, all...
Turn number one.
tucking it down. Now they start to drift out. Yellow flag is out. Yellow flag is out, folks. Look around the speedway. We don't see anybody. And oh, there it is behind a light pole. The number 22 hiding behind a light pole in the infield. That's Rich. Mike, what's it like to drive one of these legend vehicles? And he says, Ken, it's very similar to driving on ice. If you can imagine what it's like to drive on ice, that's what it's like. That's the kind of power these cars can put down. But putting it down right now, the 99 machine. Why don't you flag? Here we go. Get ice and all. Let's go. And they are battling down in the turn number one. Here we go. Two. Feel the pressure of Bates. Bates all over the back end. Give him a shot. Up at turn number two. The 76X machine. Jags Palmer hanging tough on the outside while Manafort watches this deal up in front of him. The front runners are looking at it too. Washington sitting back in that fifth spot, waiting, watching to see what's going to happen. Where to move. There goes Bates making his move around two. Up on the high side into turn number three. Across three and four. Wheel to wheel. New England legend Joyce drives it down to front end. Side by side, fender to fender, and on this battle, Q puts down to number seven, but he fights back on the high side, down the back straightaway. Late breaks into turn number three, and Q hanging tough. He's on the short way around, and now he gets that back end out a little bit. Watch the momentum and show them going into turn number one. Here comes the seven and a half to the team of Bates. Bates is hanging tough, but he goes high. He lost the momentum. Wheel to wheel, lap after lap, the New England Legends Ford Seekonk. Here he's put on a wild show at the stripe of his shoe. But now the battle continues. Up front is the seven and a half to the team. Bangs him again, but he can't get by. He can race the neck with him, but he cannot get around the 99 of Byron Chu. Sitting back, watching all this happen, Jack Palmer. While he's in the battle, he's got to fend off the 23S of John Buffington. Buffington is maintaining a consistent momentum, and he's keeping those guys within striking distance, as well as the double zero of Peter Valeri. Once again, wheel to wheel, off of turn number four. Byron Chu seems like he's playing with him. It seems as if that number 99 machine has some serious power down on the bottom two here at Seekonk Speedway. Ladies and gentlemen, Ken Isomel indicating to the field. Two laps to go. Here we go, folks. Now it's a real heated battle. Bates makes the move down into turn number one. Can't keep the momentum going. Fighting back across turn two down the back turn. The 99 at two. Trying to hold down that spot. Bates wants to cut down, but two won't let him. The white flag is up. It's going to be a drag race in a circle, folks. Who's going to get there? Bates gets the down into turn number one. Here we go. If he can get down on the bottom with that number seven, he can hold him off. He's got the power. He's got the groove. He's got two more left turns to go. The 7-8 Regina Joe Bates, ladies and gentlemen, takes the checker by a car leg. Legends Car Racing, ladies and gentlemen, at Seekonk Speedway, one of the finest exhibitions in motorsports for one of the most cost-effective ways to go racing, folks. What a battle these guys have put on. The number 99 of Byron Chu, the Buzz Chu Chevrolet Olds Incorporated machine from East Hampton, New York, putting on an excellent show, but could not hold off when it counted. The number 7 New Hampshire, Joe Bates, the F.W. Whitcomb Construction, Farmington Savings Bank, Allstead, New Hampshire driver. Semi-pro he is, folks, but he's also the national champion in the semi-pro division, Mr. Joe Bates. Right now, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the New England Legends Tours, getting with them flying high above trackside, sending it back to the regular boys here at Seekonk.
Thank you, Ken. What a beautiful display of racing here at Seekonk Speedway by the New England Legends Tours. Congratulations to Joe Bates and that 7 New Hampshire. A great, great run coming from the middle of the pack. This is a great way to start into racing. And if you look at these cars, if you like what you see, take a walk down by the concession stand located in turn number four. Check out the Speedway scene display. They've got a 1937 sedan legend car. That's from 600 Racing. They are giving that away.
And he's a champion. He did win, I think, one AAA championship too as well. Four sets of brothers. You all right, Dick Monahan? They consist of the Fenoros, the Seymours, the Paynes, and it was the Seekonks.
Okay, here we go. Steve's got the green that is ready to go, and still, we've got green. Dive to the turn one, tries to hold it down once again, and puts it safely in lead fifth. Gets underneath him to take the lead. Lead fifth, right to the tail, back to the other.
Right now, you can see the place where Brian Cleveland is in jeopardy and getting passed by John Farrell. John Farrell and Brian Cleveland asked that they are 2 qualified cars. We are taking the top 6 place. 7th spot right now, down at the bottom line spot is Greg Monroe. He's fighting to handle it. from Cleveland. To the fourth spot, fifth will be John Farrell, and sixth on the bubble is Richie Coy. So Coy makes it into the feature event.
Outside of Corey from Middleborough, the Propane Plus. Quality new order box number 96 for Rob Clark. Hailing from Todd in the 19th position in the R-Works Landscaping Captain's Quarter Deck, LL Racing, number 86 for Scott LaBelle. Starting 20th from Swansea in the JR Sign Company, Nats Racing Engines.
Kevin's professional auto detailing number 8 for Ed Gannon, the third. Rob Murray sits 21st in the Matthew Autobody Ray Light Sheet Metal Magoni's Restaurant number 08. It's Rob Murray. Next is Jimmy Hazard from Coventry in the Mac Enterprises number 12. Angelo D'Amelia in the number 5 Spotigo Masonry Silver City Dodge Fire Ride and PFS Professional Fire and Security starts 23rd. Ron Reed, Ottery Hogan from the 89 W.E. Bright Wesco Oil starts 24th. And last with a provisional starting spot in the Universal Ambulance Cycle Style number 7 is Tom Scully. We are going live racing action for 50 laps in this sportsman main event.
Billy Manchester with the jumps on the high side, and the outside of Manfred side by side. And contact. Manchester goes around, Titus goes around, and the 99 goes around, the Stella goes around, the 10 goes around, but half a dozen cars in follow. And that's before even one lap was complete.
Well, not a way to get started in this 50 lap race. He's got 50 laps the distance in this sportsman race, so plenty of time to get back up to the front for these guys. Your leader, though, Ken Goldman and Spence will be bringing them through 3 and out of 4. Al Rod looks them over. Goldman looking at the stripe. He gasses it. We're off.
Spence on the outside trying to get a good jump. Over and over down the bench. Straight away they go side by side, bumper to bumper.
Kenny Spence around the outside of Goldman. He wants to lead the lap. He could use the extra $25.
And Gannon around the bench straight away. That's going to bring us under a second caution before we can even finish a lap. Him and Billy Manchester look like they got together off the corner. And oh, everybody jumping on the binders. The 31 Goodrow and the 42 will appear going around after the caution. So
Manchester and Titus are way in the back of the pack. But 50 laps is the distance for this sportsman race.
And look who's in the middle, the 42 and the 45, last year's champion and this year's champion. It's the furthest they've started in all year, and they've got not a lot of space in front of them as we go back to green flag racing.
Golden with a good jump, and Spencer wheels them in on the outside as they go through one and out of two. Rob Murray has problems at the start-finish line as he loops the number 08.
Looks like he's trying to get that car refired, rolling it down the bottom of the track, but not before we can go back to caution.
Tough weekend here for Rob Murray. the 08. He had trouble in his pro stock. He's having trouble right now with what we call in sports. But
we
want to welcome CBI Sports on hand to take all the action. Check your local listings for cable. Also on hand with us today, Bill Channell from Channel One Video, along with Johnny Mercury, who's here each and every Saturday night.
Al Rod looks them over. Colton on the gas, gets the jump out of four. Here we go. We're back to racing. Let's complete a lap, boys. It's Colton underneath with Spencer on top. We have trouble up in two already. It's Mike Becker.
Well, Mike Becker, you can see some fluid out of the bottom of that car. And on that restart, he did get back into the 45. The front bumper got pushed up, and it looks like he may have gotten into the radiator on that number 00, Mike.
Al Rod looking him over. It's Colvin and Spencer bringing them through 3 out of 4. Colvin on the gas. The green is waved. Here we go to try again. Spencer with a good jump as he brings it into 1 and 2. Spencer on the outside of Colvin. He's trying to, oh, Colvin drifts up high. Spencer gets by. Jed Spencer could be the leader of lap one.
One lap completed. Spencer out front, second, 57. Benny just nosing out Kenny Colvin. And that number 6. Corey Boudreau, 3 high down the back straightaway on the outside of LaBelle and Clark. It's still early to be doing some moves like that, but 2 in a row we've got complete.
Oh, what a surprise. Time to stop. Who could have donated some money to the Kenny Spencer efforts? Colvin on the inside, Dean Petty on the outside. It's Willis and Morton rounding out the top 5. Kenny Spencer looking for his first win in the sports car. He's a rookie in this division. Doing a fine job now that we have been going, being able to complete a couple of laps.
Well, some of the drivers to watch deep in the back. Look, watch the number 8 as Tom Scully gets a little sideways, keeps it going though. Watch the number 8 of Ed Cannon. He's a strong runner. Each and every Saturday night, Glenn Young in the number 99, deep in the back. Billy Manchester in the 95, Rob Murray in the 08. Watch them come through the back.
Right now it's still Spencer out front having heavy pressure from Ken Colvin. And it's Dean Petty and Willis battling side by side in the same for Serendinsky and Lawton.
So we get a little jump on Petty down the back straightaway. Petty trying to hold on by. Through 3 and 4 they go, a little bit more momentum. Gets by Petty. Colvin down home, the only 4 Thunderbird in this field, running second on the track. Dana Wilson, the 55, fourth. Scott Serdinsky, the rookie, rounding out the top 5.
Spencer continuing. Now he has to hold off 2 challenges. One from the 6 of Colvin, the other one from Petty in the 57. Petty was just into his right rear quarter, but Spencer able to pull away. Looks Lawton seems to be having trouble on the outside of that number 70 car right now.
It looks like Kenny Spencer's a little bit loose going into the front. Watch the right rear tire slide just a little bit. That's going to allow Kenny Colvin down low if Spencer can't hold on.
Spencer's still in the lead. Heavy pressure from Colvin and Petty still continues. Willis runs in fourth. Serendinsky and Lawton putting on quite a battle for the 5th spot. Lawton just seems to have a slight advantage as they come across the line. He's trying to make some headway now and get by Willis and take over 4.
He's got Bobby LeClaire on his back. Remember last year's track champion. Looking to take down the 50-lap DAV Memorial feature event.
Well, it looks the longer Glenn Lawton runs, the stronger the car gets because he's starting to gain some space now on the outside, and Bobby LeClaire probably has a big smile as he's going with him.
Now look at the outside lane. Dean Petty in the number 57. Looks like he may have led that lap, but it was close. Bobby LeClaire dropping back a couple of spots out of turn number 4. Spencer down low. Petty up high, and it's a dead heat across the line.
I'm not sure, but I think Bobby LeClaire might have a left front going down. Yes, he does. I am pretty sure Bobby LeClaire has the left front going down to the number 42 car. Dean Petty coming across. He's the new leader.
Well, Petty gets going to the high side. He's all alone out front. Spencer back to second. Third, it's Kenny Colvin at the number 6. Serdinsky making the run on the inside of Dana Willis. The 42 LeClaire trying to hold on. The left front tire, that's a tough one in his car. He doesn't know he's got a problem in that car, but it is flat all the way down to the wheel. He's going to have to call it an afternoon. Everybody trying to get by behind.
Oh, trouble on the back stretch between the two of the tightest before the hazard. The 99 of Young goes around.
Well, Manchester gets in the back of him. Young spins it down the infield. And the number 2 of Dave Titus, that car leaking
looks like some overflow water off the track.
Well, this is a good break for Bobby LeClaire. He can now bring that 42 into the pit, get a new left front, and be able to come back out in competition without losing a lap.
People had a wonderful fall afternoon. It's been a great season for all the
Petty and Spencer, they're on the front row. They're going to be bringing them through three and out of four. Al Rod looks them over. Petty's at the stripe. He hits the gas. The green is out. We're back to live racing action this fourth and 50 lap. Petty takes the lead. Going in through one and out of two. Spencer drifts a little high. Colvin gets some room. Puts his number 6-4 Thunderbird underneath Spencer for the second spot. Lawton right on Colvin's bumper. Trying to move through with him and take over the third spot. Steve Ribby, the number 18, having some problems as he drifts way back. It looks like he might have a flat right front tire. Let's see if you can see that. Maybe not, but he does have a problem in the number 18 as he was running right up front and now he's way off the base. We have trouble down in 3 and 4. Glenn Lawton in the number 70 has come to a complete stop right in turn 3. Oh, and the 63 of Spencer goes around now in turn 2 and he gets clipped by the 86 of LaBelle.
With Goodrow in the 31 car on turn 2, we are under our fifth.
Once again, we have caution out in this sportsman main event.
Legend Key Turn Operation can go racing in 1997. Looking for a green this time by Petty and Coleman. Your front row green is out. We're back underway. And Petty is getting a good jump. He's got 7 inches all over the back bumper with Coleman falling back to third. Sitting fourth on the field, your track champion Scotty Estrella in the number 45, trying to get underneath Coleman as Coleman starts to slip a little on the outside. Petty trying to open up a little bit of distance over here for the rest of the field. Zirnitsky sits second. The 45 from Estrella third, Coleman fourth, and Corey Boudreau with the Pink Panther sits fifth. Half a hood up from the 196. But as it's unfortunate he can't see, he's going to call it an event.
Well, Petty is still your leader with Zirnitsky sitting second and your track champion Scotty Estrella running in third. Petty looking for his second one of the season. Zirnitsky looking for his first. Estrella looking for his second. His first came in the previous 50 lap for these sportsmen guys. The 96 has just stopped right at the pit bottom. He's trying to get it in. He finally does. We'll stay under green. Tight racing right now between the 89 of Reed, the 6 of Goldman, and the 21 of Corey Boudreau. Petty is still your leader, but he has heavy pressure from the 22 and the 45. They're pulling away from the rest of the pack. The top three are moving on. Then you have Reed running fourth, Goldman fifth, Woodrow sixth. Eddie Gannon trying to take over seventh. Corey Boudreau, Bobby LeClaire has made it all the way back up to ninth. Manchester sits 10th, Fibber 11th, Young 12th. But Dean Petty continues to lead this race, and he has been picking up quite a bit of lap money here in this sportsman feature event. Is now halfway. Oh, Eddie Gannon gets sideways. Colvin gets sideways. It's Petty, Zirnitsky, Estrella, Reed, Goodrow, Gannon, LeClaire, and Colvin. It is still Petty, still Zirnitsky, and Estrella, the old top three. The rest of the field is a little further back. Ryan Reed trying to close the gap and reel in the number 45. Catching him and then passing him is a whole different ballgame, though. Petty still continuing to lead this race. He's racking up the money for the last sponsors. That is for sure, but I know he just wants to lead the last lap, which will be the checkered flag lap. Your top 10 right now is Petty, Zirnitsky, Estrella, Reed, Goodrow on the top five, Gannon 6, LeClaire 7, Colvin 8, Fibber 9, and Manchester is back up in 10.
Well, Dean Petty beginning to roll away a little bit from Zirnitsky in that number 22, and he's got Scotty Estrella on his back bumper, Ron Reed, in that number 89 since Courtney started off this season with a win, wants to end it with a win, but he's got some distance to make up.
Estrella looking for the low side of Scotty, Zirnitsky, Zirnitsky shuts the door, Estrella still has to hold on for third right now. We are more than halfway through this 50-lap feature event for all the sportsmen.
Petty holding on. He's got a 10-car length advantage over Sukai Zirinditsky in that number 22. Zirinditsky trying to hold on a second, but he's got a hot drive with the number 45. Scotty is all over the back bumper. Your 1996 champion wants to go out with a win.
You can see now LeBron Reed is slightly closing the gap on the 45. He's running a distant, though, fourth of the 45 right now. Souza back underneath the track champion of 95. Oh, we have trouble in four. And the trouble as it goes around, everyone makes it through, though. And the yellow gets out once again. Well, right now is the time to announce the second half. Petty and Zirinditsky are on your front row. Petty will bring them through three out of four. Al Rod looking them over. Petty waiting for the stripe. You can tell he's anxious. He hits the stripe, he gives the gas, he drifts up a little. That little leaves room for Scotty Estrella. Zirinditsky to the high side. Estrella pulls back in. Holds on to third right now. He looks for room on the second. We have a problem with Bobby Glasgow. Number 42 slows on the back shoot. Right now, though, your leader is still Dean Petty in the number 57. Tough break for your 1995 track champion, Bobby LeClair. This looks like it'll end his day and maybe his career in the sports division as he is rumored to be going to pro stocks next season. Dean Petty, still your leader in the 57. Estrella makes a nice move on the Scotty Zirinditsky, the winner of the last 50 lapper. He is now up to second. Your track champion, Scotty Estrella, the New England Tire and Battery Motion Motors. Estrella's bomb, number 45, is all over the bumper of Petty.
Well, Estrella's looking to take down two 50-lap races in 1996. Sits second. Only Dean Petty sits between him and the checker. Ed Gannon, look at him. Moves to the high side. And oh, the 15 car trying to get in the infield. He's got some problems on that car.
Rallo a band for, yeah, he wasn't close enough. He could see Rob Murray going by, but he almost took Rob Murray right out as he tried to throw this car out of harm's way into the infield. Petty, still your leader in that number 57. We have two cars spun around in three and four. The 12th has it, the 55 on Willis and Tom Scully. And now Fibber McGee loops it, and no one collects Fibber down in turn three.
Well, that makes you wonder if the 15 put down any fluid in that corner, as he saw some steam coming out of the front end of that engine. Possibly right on their back bumpers as they come down for the restart.
You'll watch Petty bring him through three. He'll be coming out of four, looking at the stripe. He'll be mashing the gas, looking for Al Rod's green flag as he can get going. Petty and Estrella, your new front row. See Petty get a little anxious now. He's got the stripey hand as he gets a good jump. Leave some room for Scotty Zirinditsky, but the battle is still up front between Petty and Estrella. Estrella to the high side. Petty brings him up high. Petty continues to lead. Now Zirinditsky able to sneak the 22 under Estrella as he tries to take over a second spot.
Well, Estrella's going to look for a 45 to run up high if he can get back on the outside of the 57. That's going to leave the door open down low. Petty holding his own, holding that groove, wants to win this feature event.
If Petty's still leading, he's definitely collecting a lot of lap money.
And oh, good guy goes around.
Oh, good coach. Oh, he collects the 18, sends him into the wall. Fibber McGee spins. He's stuffed by LaBelle, who has nowhere to go into his left front. What a through three and out of four. Estrella sits third, Reed fourth, Colvin rounds out the top five. Petty looking for his second win of the season. Zirinditsky looking for his first. Estrella looking for his second, which would be his second 50-lapper if he was able to pull this one off. And they're off, and the green is given. Petty drifts high once again. Closes the ball, though, on Estrella. Zirinditsky now has to go to the high side. Can Estrella get back in second spot? Zirinditsky looks real strong up high. This time by, and still Petty right now coming out of four. Estrella trying to take over second, but Zirinditsky holds on this time by.
Zirinditsky trying to hold on to the outside. Estrella down low, down the back straightaway, running for that second spot. Dean Petty, you're up front with 10 laps remaining.
10 to go this time by, and now Scotty Estrella has come back to take over the second spot. He's looking low this time on. Oh, we have trouble again as Spencer is going around into.
Spencer just losing it all by himself off that second corner, and that's going to bring us under another caution for this event. And that's got to be like caution number 408.
Patty bringing him down through three and out of four. Gets to the stripe, he hits the gas, drifts up high once again. Can he hold Serendipio? He's just the door on Serendipio. Estrella battling side by side. We have a good, good battle going on for the lead. Serendipio looking for some daylight, trying to take over the second spot from Estrella. Estrella up high, trying to get the lead away from Patty. Serendipio sails it in now, tries to take over second from Estrella. They're door to door right now. Reed's balling back in the 89. Manchester gets under him. Young's up to four. Reed gets sideways coming out of four. He holds it on though. No one gets selected in that mishap. Glenn Moore to the inside of Bobby McLaren. Serendipio now to the inside of Estrella. This is only helping out Team Petty right now as these two battle. Oh, Estrella gets sideways coming out on four. Serendipio is running second. Estrella third. Young fourth. Manchester fifth. Serendipio is now taking over sole possession of second place. It's Petty, Serendipio, Estrella, Young, and Manchester for the all top five. Ron Reed is starting to push White Savalian, the number 89 sportsman car. Lawton now underneath him. Lawton's moving up until seventh spot. Five to go. He gets sideways. Serendipio's got some inside running room. As we come by, oh, Serendipio gets crossed up. Now we get Team Petty back in the lead. Serendipio falls back to second. Young gets a little sideways. Estrella's third. Young fourth. Oh, you can see Ron Reed getting a little tap. It's Team Petty is your leader, though. He's trying to hold off. Manchester goes around in turn four. Another yellow is out. With less than five laps to go in this Sportsman 50 lap of Billy Manchester in the 95 has gone around right out of turn four.
Glenn Young sits in fourth. He loves these extra distance races. Had to come from the back of the pack after a lap zero incident. And we'll see what he can do in these next four laps. But he's got three cars ahead of Estrella, Serendipio, and Petty.
Petty brings him through three. Out of four, he gets the jump. He brings him up high again. The green is out. As they go into one and two, they're door to door. Now Estrella sails his number 45 underneath the 22.
And look at the
Bobby
LeClaire
makes it three wide. Pushes the 86 into Lawton. Now Bobby LeClaire is losing his hood.
Well, that's what may happen sometimes. You can see the hood slamming on the number 42 car as he sits fifth on the field. That, I guess, is not hampering his vision.
Two to go. The Dean Petty, Scotty Estrella, Serendipio, and Young. Whoa, here we go again. Do we have some excitement there? Scotty Estrella tries to sail it in underneath. One to go, and Petty Estrella fighting for the win. Can Estrella get a good run?
Estrella giving it all he's got, going high, low, otherwise getting that car sideways through the corners. Coming out of four to the checker flag, it's going to be Dean Petty. Over Scott Estrella, Glenn Young, Serendipio, and Bobby LeClaire for the finish. What a great race. Dean Petty leading from early on, picking up a bunch of lap money. Whoa, so and Serendipio right, bouncing off the 99 and the 42. Obviously, he is not happy about something. His second victory of the 1996 season. Driving the Bristol County Modular Home. Precision Auto Body Quality Coach Sales, number 57. It's Dean Petty taking down the win, waiting for some traffic to clear in front of him so he can take his victory lap.
Way to go.
Dean Petty trying to make his way through the stop field and get through all these throws. Beautiful modified. Wow, there's a close one there. Dean Petty able to throw right through the door with a nice Vermont road walk. Congratulations, 57 Dean Petty.
Look, you're going to win one. This is the one to win. Not only is it an extra distance race, it's got lap money. And lap money is also popular with these drivers. And he probably led a good 30, 35 laps, and at $25 a lap, that's a big plus for these drivers. Taking down the victory lap, out of Minnesota Mass, number 57, give him a big round of applause. Dean Petty holding off some hot challenges. Caution lights out, looking for green next time by Tom Sherman, Dick Dubois, your front row.
No, it ain't.
two cars that aren't even on here.
DeRozier and Casey, your front row.
DeRozier and Casey, your front row. Looking for green this time by. Green flag is up. We are underway. DeRozier getting a jump on Logan Casey on the outside, trying to get that front spot third. It's the 54 of Kevin Konopka, the 25 right there of Gary Russell.
And look at George Savory already going to the front and ready to say bye-bye.
Savory absolutely loves Seekonk Speedway. He's a many-time feature winner here at Seekonk Speedway. Just look at the money. He's got all the feature wins there for everybody to see.
Casey, though, has a decent lead right now over the 12th of DeRozier and the 25th of Casella. Savory in the 21 trying to work his way up to the front. He gets by Sherman in the 13. Looks to the outside of DeRozier trying to take over third.
Well, the 7 of Chris Norton got a problem. He's way back to field. Just a couple of laps in where he's looking to get left. The 30 of Ruff also having a problem. And the 23 goes on. That's Mark McDonald. He's in the infield.
Casey Alita, Casella running second, but here he comes, the multi-time winner, George Savory.
Black flag being shown for the number 72 car of Sylvia Brunden. She's got a problem in that automobile. Well, it's Casey in the out front, the 25 of Casella, and the 21 of Savory, 1, 2, 3. Casella with a good jump on the outside of Casey as they go 2, 2, 3, and 4.
Well, remember, Kevin, I talked about this is going, but I thought the 25 was very fast in the qualifying. We have trouble as the 72 of Sylvia. Front row is made up of Mike Casey and George Casella, Gary Casella, sorry, in the number 25. Gary is a rookie on the Pro 4 Modified Tour this year.
Well, green flag is on Casella with a good jump, and he's got Savory on his back from the smoke and from the 25 as he tries to hold on up high. Savory down low and looking to go down, and then he picks up Casey down the front straightaway looking for that lead.
Casella keeping that number 25 on, running pretty strong as he tries the outside of Casey. Savory's locked in by the number 8 of Casey. Savory again tries the low side, but Casey slams the dog and got.
Well, Savory looking high or otherwise. Casella up high, Casey on the inside. Savory looking for an opening, trying to get by. Meanwhile, the 21X of Eddie Holiak trying to work his way through the field, trying to get by the number 9 of J.R. Lumman. Oh, he's got a problem. Holiak is all done.
Tough break for Eddie Holiak to cover some mass data. But right now you have a new leader. The 25 of Gary Casella is taking over the lead. Well, Mike Casey, we come by the stop finish line. It's Casella, Savory, and Casey.
Well, Savory following through and trying to make a win. Slice and dice through the field, trying to get by Casey. Casey coming back again strong on the inside.
Right now, the 25 of Gary Casella is doing a dynamite job of holding on to that lead. He has the two tough entries, Savory and Casey, right behind him.
Well, Casey's running the high group. That's where his car was the best. That leads to the bottom wide open. Savory loves this speedway. Loves the inside lane, and you're going to watch him try to go underneath Casella from the turn number 4 down the straightaway. They go.
Casella's
still
able to handle George Savory right now. Casey's falling back a bit from third. The road to hold on to 4, Sherman and Canada battling from fifth.
Casella still holding off Savory for that one spot. Savory looking long for the lap cars. We'll be coming across the next couple of laps. Savory down low, Casella. 2 turns, 3 and 4. Out of the fourth corner, it's Savory. Oh, I don't know. I think Casella still get that one. But Savory's got the bottom move. Lap cars now. We're going to be coming across. Savory uses it to advantage over Casella. He takes over the lead all by himself.
Halfway through this Pro 4 Modified feature, your leader is George Savory now. Looks like the smoking clouds have caught up to the 25 of Casella as he has slowed. Probably with engine problems.
Tough break for Casella, led early on in the race, and he's going to have to call today. That gives the lead all over to Savory. He's got a 20 car length lead over his closest competitor. In the number 8, that's Mike Casey.
Yeah, Savory is just trying to walk away right now with this. I'm sure he's probably not even punishing the car too much because he's got a good lead over the 8 of Mike Casey. All he has to do right now is get through this last group of lap cars and he should have a smooth run through the checking.
Well, lap cars could become a problem. We saw it last week at a different speedway in a different division. We've seen it time and time again. The lap cars become a factor and
have an outcome on the end of the race with Savory dominating this race as he normally does. Casey runs second, the road runs third, Sherman's walk, and outcome with them. Savory has made it through most of the left end right now. He's moving his way to look for the check-in. We have a problem right there with the 19. Two to go! Two to go!
Well, Savory all alone out front. He's got a long way ahead to the checkered flag, the 19 of Harry Wheeler, stopping on the front straightaway, and that's going to bring us on the car from just a couple of laps left. It looks like we're going to go green-white checker when we go back to green. That's going to close up the gap between Savory and Casey. Casey always runs well at this track, a former competitor in the sportsman division here weekly, and now he's got his sights set on George Savory. He finished third earlier this year. It should be green, white, and checker for the finish of this Pro 4 modified 30-lap main event. It's a jump early in the turn. Savory gets the advantage, and he's out front second. It's the 8 of Casey. Sherman third, DeRozier in the 12. Sits fourth with a good battle for fifth between Gorman and Konopka. Out of turn number 4, Savory all alone out front. He's got about a 20.
Oh, in trouble in 2 is Bobby Blanchett. Lost possibly a radio hose from Wallace.
A slow start down the back straightaway. Savory and Casey bringing them down. This is the third restart with 7 laps remaining. This looks a lot better. Green flag is out. We're backing away. Savory gets the advantage. He's up front. Casey, Sherman, and the Rosie atop 4 cars.
Savory, real strong
jump
this time. Nice and home. Like the looks of it. Savory has continued to lead this race. Sherman's going to press hard with Casey now.
Well, Casey is a former competitor here at Seekonk Speedway, and Sherman's got some problems in that 13 with just a handful of laps remaining, and he's going to call it quits with 5 to go. Savory continuing to open up the lead, only Casey to number 8, Rick DeRozier in the 12, Kevin Konopka for the 54, and the 5, that's Joe Doucette, who's moved up into the 5th spot with just a few laps remaining. That car is extremely sideways on the corners. He's got a problem. He continues to lose ground on the rest of the track. The 24 is slow. That's Ken Burnett. He's at the back of the field. Savory continuing to pull away. This time by Kenny Icebone shows on the 6. 2 laps remain for the Westwood Mass Stadium of George Savory. Casey still holding on a second. The road to third. Get up there on the top 4 out of the 4th corner. White flag is down, just 4 turns remaining. Savory out front continues to open up. Down the back straightaway, he goes for the final time into turn 3 and 4. On a pulling up, Kenny Icebone, he's waving the red, then black and white flag. And George Savory takes double win as the 41 spins off into the wall. That's a dark one, Sponsnick, in that 41 after the checker flag flies. But taking the win, his second of the season here at Seekonk Speedway, out of Westwood, Mass, driving the Riverside Speedway out of Groveton, New Hampshire, number 21. Give him a big round of applause for George Savory.
Well, George Savory puts another win in his record books from 1996. He won all but I think 2 or 3 races this season.
Competitors, wave your hats, wave your hands, ladies and gentlemen. Show them that you appreciate midget racing in the Northeast. Only the best are gonna go 4 abreast. Look at that, doesn't that look beautiful? Come on, ladies and gentlemen, get up on your feet. Let them know that you appreciate this type of open wheel racing. The next time by, we're gonna put them back in 2x2 formation, and from then on, we're going racing.
And as we get back down to 2 this time by, it'll be Chuck Welling and John Payne on the front row. And then we'll have Doki Panoro and Rudy Buttinger in the second row. Then Brian Kobolas and Joey Payne. Mike Seymour and Drew Panoro side by side in the next row. Then Joey Coy and Babe Shaw.
Steve Dumas points to the line the next time by. The green flag's going to be in the air. Chuck Welling and John Payne are going to bring him down. This is the Northeastern Midget Association. 35 laps, 24 cars strong. Chuck Welling, John Payne are going to bring him down. Steve Dumas is going to let him go.
Outside, gets by Welling, takes the quick lead down the back stretch. Down the back stretch. Oh,
we
got a bad one.
We have a flip. John Farrell on his head.
We have two cars. One car on its side. John Farrell is upside down. The red flag is out. We got a little bit too wide there in turns one and two.
A whole lot of cars scrambling, a whole lot of cars moving around at the start. We saw John Farrell catch a wheel and get upside down. Don DeLapp also sitting on his side in the middle of turn number two. Brian Cleveland, Matt O'Brien also involved, as well as the 77 of Mike Legell. Down the back straightaway, Chuck Welling and John Payne are going to bring him down for 35 laps. Here they go, coming off of turn number four.
Gets the lead, and once again we get a three wide going to the back of the track, and this time everybody made it. John Payne has the early lead to Robin Joey, is coming roaring on the outside in that number three car.
Driver has lost power, he's slowing down and we're pulling to the infield. The top five races, John Payne, ladies and gentlemen.
of the lap guard. Joey Bain on the outside, Drew Bernard on the inside, and Drew Bernard just on the inside of Joey Bain as the yellow comes out. Yellow flag. That's Rudy Buster and has lost it in turn four.
As the halfway point, these midgets will go into a single file formation. We have almost reached, oh, with five to go, I'm sorry, I've been misinformed, but they will go to a double file restart this time by.
Matt Dunkey got a great start because that was a lap car. The double zero of Richie Boy was a lap car. Second position here. Here goes with the halfway side. That's 17 laps now. Joey Bernard on the front. Joey Payne, Drew Bernard, Brian, double launch. Lou Ciccone, and here comes Joey Boy around the outside. Tonight is Nick Bonoro Sr.
Nick Bonaro Sr., one of the great midget drivers of all times, was here to watch his two sons finish 1-2, battling all the way.
The patriarch of the Fenoro Racing clan, a former AAA big car champion, he now sees both of his sons. It's got to be doing this father very, very proud to see both of his sons sitting first and second in the feature event.
And Noki Fenoro, by the way, we mentioned that Drew has won 6 NEMA champions.
Going on, they're all over from New England down here this weekend. 28 of the best drivers. Stand up, wave them on, let them know you care.
Wave your hats, wave your program shirts, anything you have. Let these drivers know you appreciate that they've been here each and every Saturday night. The regulars, the outsiders, give them a big wave. The drivers are waving back to all the fans in the track. Come on, folks, down in turns 1 and 2, give them a big wave. Round of applause for all 28 drivers. 42 cars signed in. 14 unable to make it for the big event. Come on, 100 laps of open competition pro stocks. Can an outsider take down the $5,000 victory put up by Burnham Boilers and Reardon Supply? Can a regular take home the big money? Now Rodriguez looking for the green this time by. He likes what he sees, and we are underway. Got that 14 Camaro hook. He was turning times yesterday faster than I've seen in a long time in a pro car. Flying pretty stealth third. Look at the battle up front. There's lap money at stake for all 20, all for all, 100 laps.
Should be still continuing to lead the race. That is Johnny Tripp in the 88 this weekend. Remember, Johnny Tripp, Bobby's father, piloting the number 88. Martin giving it all he can to the outside of Johnny.
Bobby driving the number 80. He's in sixth on the midline as he's got Mike Holder on the restart.
Oh, McCallum gets into the back of Freddie, and he goes around coming out of two. McCallum spins on the grass on the back track.
And that's going to bring us under our first question of this 100-lap event. Tough break. Jimmy McCallum starting on the inside of the third row, running fourth, but unfortunately going around off the second corner.
Trippy and Martin sit on the front row. Once again, that is Johnny Tripp, not Bobby. Bobby's driving the 80 tonight.
Looking for green this time by Al Rodriguez. Likes what he sees. And Johnny Tripp with a great jump. Martin trying to hold on the outside. Good running show right there in third.
Well, the top four is dominated by the Westport boys. Trippy, Martin, Estelle, and Trippy.
Oh, Johnny Tripp out front leads another lap. That's $100 a lap. But he out of the floor having problems. Back in the back.
Top break from a very good answer made with a number 66 PC container service. Really strong on the back too. Johnny Tripp is still out there.
The 66 of the third and bring that car back into the pits. A tough, tough break all the way from Delhi, New Hampshire. A regular competitor here at Seekonk Speedway. Johnny Tripp still leading us down. Second is Tripp on the 14. Third is Bobby Tripp. He runs that car everywhere. That's his open competition car. He's run that at Oxford, at Lee, and at Thompson, and he is booked.
I'll tell you right now, Bobby Tripp is just sailing that car in the turns. I don't see a car working better. Turns right now, that's the 80 car. But it's Trippy, Martin, Trippy, and Estelle.
Johnny Tripp driving the same car that Bobby Tripp drove for the 1995 Pro Stock Championship and the tie for the 96 title as well. Field starting to thin out just a little bit. The only one up front, Rick Martin on the outside, trying to get by the 88 of Johnny Tripp. The couple of balls in line. The next car on the outside is way back. Many in a moment. Now look at the outside of David Hutchins in the number 96.
Well, it's still Trippy. Martin Trippy is one three right now. They are both with us. Johnny Tripp gets a little swirly coming around. Martin gets the edge coming out of four. Rick Martin will lead this lap as he comes by to take over the lead away from Johnny Tripp.
Well, Johnny hasn't given up yet. Oh, a little bit of contact. Martin gets squirrely off the corner. That puts Johnny Tripp back out front. And look who's right behind. Hey, you're not seeing double, ladies and gentlemen. That's the 88 of Johnny Tripp and the 80 of Bobby Tripp. Both owned by Dick Jiggins. Father and son racing right there.
Well, what a battle this is up front, I'll tell you. They are putting on some show.
The top three continue to pull away from the rest of the field. The look at Bobby Higgins. He's been working the outside of somebody else. He's won these races before. They're at Seekonk Speedway. They wants to go home today $5,000 richer.
Freddy still sees the floor. Plays the distance for a little back bumper of Bobby Tripp. Then he goes around top of the top five. Goes to the top 10 of fuel. Jimmy Rosenfield, Tommy Rose, Marco, and Steve Channing right now. Rounding out the top 10.
Oh, back of the 24 is on fire.
You can see a fire on the 24 car. There is fire on the 24 car.
The 24 is on fire. The fuel cell on fire on that automobile. We'll see if he can drive that right to the fire truck. The fire truck is in the infield. And we're going to go quickly to a red flag situation to try to get that 24 out. Dave Bergman does not know what's happening. Lenny Ellis pulls upside and lets him know, pointing to the fuel cell, your car is burning.
He's stopping that car. We have the 41 car. Lenny Ellis stopping, I'm sure, to make sure that
so that has been red flag right now. So hopefully Dave Bergman can get out of that car and they can get the fire contained. David is out of the vehicle.
David's out of the car. Tough break for him as he was running mid-pack, trying to get that car situated, get settled, and trying to work his way towards the front in the latter stages of the race. You don't want to see that happen, and you know it's an unfortunate. Possibly a fuel line may have broken on that number 50, on that number 24K. And just early in the race, he's still got plenty of time to work his way towards the front.
The caution lights are out. It's Johnny Tripp and Rick Martin on the front row. Bobby Tripp and Freddie bring up the row behind. The four top guys out from Westport, Mass. And here they go. What a jump by Johnny Tripp again.
Johnny's number 88. Johnny's been able to get the jump every time, but Martin is right down the outside. But right now, he's got the tying. The tie man, tied to the championship, Bobby Tripp has a race right all over the track.
Freddie has to force too much ground on this restart. He's staying right there with Bobby Tripp this time. Charlie Rose trying to make a move on the outside. He's up to Jimmy Rosenfield's wall. Kenny Rose comes up. He is on the back of Jimmy Hughes.
Jimmy Hughes has been able to work his way through the field pretty well. He's got it back in the ninth spot. Now sits fifth on the field. He's been able to work the high line, the low line. This is his first time with that car here. See, a roller is sideways off the corner. Charlie Rose trying to hold on to the high side. He's got Rosenfield down low right behind him with 23. That's Steve Channing, the former Pro 4 Modified champion.
It is still Johnny Tripp, Rick Martin, and Bobby Tripp, your top three. Freddie's hit the ball, Jimmy Field is fifth.
Trying the high line once again to go around, but Johnny Tripp in the number 88. They run 1, 2, 3, gives him a little touch off the corner, lets him know he's here, and Johnny will give him all the room on the outside, but just don't try to go underneath.
If you look deeper back in the pack though, Charlie Rose and Jimmy Rosenfield, a strong standing, quite a battle.
Well, that's not as good as the battle we got up front. Rick Martin back to the outside. He's got the momentum this time. Into turns 3 and 4. Tripp down low, Martin up high. Side by side up the corner, and Martin leads his second lap of the night.
Martin doing a fabulous job on the outside tonight. Johnny Tripp doing a very dynamite job himself on the low side. Bobby Tripp is just hanging back. Just a tad, just in case something was to happen.
Well, he's looking for a hole. Last year, he absolutely dominated this race. With just over 10 laps to go, he got involved with Chad Chase as they raced for the win with just 7 laps remaining. He sits third now and watches his dad and his fellow Westport man, Rick Martin, battle for the lead. Johnny Tripp down low, Rick Martin up high, still side by side out front. Great racing action.
Channing has made a move now under the 91 right now. Steve Channing is making a good strong run to get to the front.
And we've got a new leader, Rick Martin, all alone up front. He's got that front spot to himself, and he slams the door on Johnny Tripp. Johnny back to second, Bobby Tripp in third. And it looks like Martin wants to check out. Freddie Estelle Jr. sits fourth, and Jimmy Q fifth, but they've got a lot of ground in front of them for the top three.
Rick Martin does look like a superior car once he gets out of the front. He's in the car just at the turn. Really, really comfortable being out of the lead, and so is the Rick. And he's running a strong line in the car just next to the rail. Real good right now.
Steve Channing looking for the outside of 44 of Jimmy Rosenfield, trying to work his way into that seventh spot. A
taking the high line deep in the back, trying to go to the outside of Honey Elf's number 41 as he tries to whip his way to the front.
Vaughn continues to lead as the Drippy men play battle now for second and third. Freddy still holding on to fourth. The distance has widened from third to fourth. There's about a 15-mile length difference from third to fourth place right now.
Well, Freddy is down, trying to hold on to that fourth spot. He's got Jimmy Q all over the back bumper. Q looking high, looking low or otherwise, trying to get into the top four and see if he can catch the top three before they get away too far.
You got to walk a little deeper in the pack. And on the outside, the 50 of Bobby Gahan and the M80 of Larry Delinas. They are up to 12th and 13th respectively. They're trying to crack the top 10 and make a strong run to get to the front and hold the gorgeous so they can reel these leaders in.
Well, Delinas has never seen Seekonk Speedway before yesterday, and it bit him hard at the beginning. At the beginning of the race, he went out in the warm-ups and hit the first turn wall. They worked hard to get that car ready, and he's got that car moving very well throughout the field.
McMahon is starting to extend his lead over the 88 Johnny Tripp. And within a few laps, we'll see McMahon. Oh, Johnny Tripp has a problem coming off too.
Well, Johnny gets slideways off the corner. Bobby Tripp tries to get underneath, but Johnny shuts the door. That puts Rick Martin that much further ahead as they try to catch the leader, Rick Martin.
Very soon you'll see the leader stop lapping the back car there. John Henshaw sitting on the bubble of being lapped. Very soon.
Right in front of him, Dick Houlihan and Alan LaFleur. LaFleur, I believe, is already a few laps down because he did have to bid on the green flag. Houlihan has already made his trip into the pits once. Hard and clean racing throughout the field. Larry Gelinas in the M80 working his way forward. Right behind him, he's got the elbow. Jimmy McKellen and that Deuce trying to work their way through and just cracking the top 10.
Well, I noticed before Bobby Gahan ducked his number 50 down to the bottom real quick. Better make him a bid to go back up top. He must have a problem. He does have a problem. The theory of Mike Bola. Having trouble as he came out of board is slowed tremendously.
Well, he slowed tremendously as Rick Martin's already into lap traffic as he's already gone by the 30 to 1 and the 30X.
Another young man out there having a good night tonight so far is the 43 of Kenny Cole. He's sure getting that car around him for the first time to see Garvin Rosa.
Well, he's not, I'm very familiar with the Trackman Sportsman's cars here for many, many years. And now sits behind the wheel of the number 43 Pro Stock.
Larry Gelinas, he is the man on the move right now on the outside. And with him comes the outlaw, Tim McCallum, in the Hydrostop Roofing number 2.
Well, think they've got to watch out for. They don't want to burn up their tires too early. The McCreary's crashed, and oh, the two almost get together. Gelinas and McCallum almost getting into it. And we've got a battle for that fourth spot.
Jimmy Q is now getting underneath the 48 of Freddy Estelle, and Kenny Cole is getting out of the bumper of Q trying to follow suit.
Well, not only that, we've got a change in position for position number 2. Bobby Tripp has gotten by Dad John, and he's only one car length. Look, I think I'm seeing triple, though. That's Mike Fuller in the number 30. That's his own car, the 80 and the 88. Different cars, different drivers, different owners. Those are owned by Jake DeGear. And oh, the 30 getting slideways in front of Bobby Tripp off the corner.
Well, I'll tell you right now, Rick Martin is just checking out from everyone on the speedway. These drivers, I don't want to see anything bad, but they're definitely praying for a caution.
Well, they
try to reel them in.
Well, they definitely need
it. Oh, and once again, you see the two of the M80 getting together.
And Kubarko is loose. That car is slideways off the corner extremely. I talked to the drivers before the race. The track is slick. The track is loose. We got to get the cars tight. Let them loosen up as the race goes on. There probably may not be a second group, but I think McCallum and Gelinas are disproving that theory.
Well, I'll tell you, Rick Martin has just been awesome. He was here last Saturday for practice. The car was out doing 12-6. Going to talk to Vinny Anarulo. Vinny said he had his one set to his small base. He was probably pretty good. Then when he saw Martin doing 12-6, he just did that.
Martin's right now behind two crowds battling for position behind Norm Holden and the 96 of David Hutchins as he tries to get to the left traffic as quickly as possible because he's got a big lead over Bobby Tripp and that number 8. He's got a straightaway lead over the second place car.
have given them a tap to the 96 of Hutchins. Those two have been competitive all season long. They've become good friends. David Hutchins thanking Rick Martin all season long. He's been a tremendous help to him getting that car set up.
Well, McCallum is moved by Rosenfield. Here comes Delina to the M80. They're closing in on Kenny Gola this time by.
Well, the 66 of McClure back into the pit area of the green. He's going to go more laps down. Tough breaks for the Dairy New Hampshire driver. Al Rod looking him over, Ed Yarrington Jr. right there beside him on the starter stand, the assistant setter, looking for a green this time by. Will Martin be able to pull away as he has been so far? Will Bobby Tripp stay with him? Green flag is out and we are backing away. Oh, what a great job Martin got.
I'll tell you, he's doing good, Kevin. That car is so strong. Bobby Tripp trying to reel it in. Chad Chase has a problem. So does the 30X of Todd Henshaw.
Well, Jelinas had a great jump that time. Got by Kohler, Chase. By the time they hit turn number two, and he's up to seventh. I'm sorry, he's up to sixth. Martin trying to pull away, but he's got Bobby Tripp in that number 80 right behind.
Well, we are going to have another caution. Todd Henshaw is slowed up in turn two in the 30X. The caution flag is out once again.
Caution light is on the speedway, looking for a green this time by Martin and Trippi on your front row. The past two champions here at Seekonk Speedway. Al Rodriguez looking him over, likes what he sees, and Martin again with a good jump, but Trippi on the outside trying to hold on. And McCallum trying to gain a few spots. And oh, Channing goes around off the second corner. A bunch of cars trying to avoid it. The Caparco looks like Lenny Ellis in the 41 went around. Chad Chase got some right foot damage. Started almost last in the field, 25th, and he's up to 5th. With 37 laps remaining, he is flying.
Martin and Trippi are on the front row. It's Trippi and Kuhn in the second row. Martin with another fabulous jump off the start as he continues to lead this 100 lap pro stock open.
Well, Bobby Tripp trying to hold on. Johnny looking underneath. Jimmy Kuhn right there and Joe Linus riding out the top five. Joe Linus looking underneath Kuhn through three and four, and it looks like he's got that fourth spot.
Oh, Eddie Kohler goes around right at the start finish line. McCallum goes around, and no one is collected in that incident.
But Kohler straightened it out, but got it sideways again off the second corner. The 96 of Hutchins gets involved, but caution light is out, looking for a green flag next time by. 37 laps remain. Bobby Tripp trying to take down the win, but he's got Rick Martin in front of him. Martin has been getting great restarts each time. Can he get another one? Not as good this time, but it's still a good restart as Trippy got a good one that time.
Yeah, Bobby Tripp had a real good run off the turn that time, but Martin still has the advantage. He continues to lead this show right now. Bobby Tripp working the high side and Rick Martin.
Martin down out front. The 80 of Trippy second, the 88 of Trippy third, and a good battle for Boston Linus playing the inside of Jimmy Kuhn, but Kuhn slams the door.
Kuhn having a very good run here today in the number 72 guy. He started out the season with the 0-1-4 that is now being piloted by Rick Hanifel.
Well, Rick was up in the lead last Saturday and Sunday, and destroying a motor, and he was unable to make it. Jelinas a little high off that fourth corner. It looks like he may have been having some damage in the race.
Well, I'll tell you, Rick Martin is just so strong today. It looks like he is going to be untouchable once under the race. He is running a dynamite race, and the Chippy men are right there also.
But father and son trading bumper pads as Bobby Tripp trying to hold off Dad. Rick Martin continues to pull away. Jimmy McCallum pulls that number two into the pit area.
Martin is still your leader. That is Trippy, Kuhn, Zelinas, Kohler, and Pelham. The two buddies, they are battling the position on the speedway.
Oh, looks like Zelinas may have a problem. We've got a problem off the fourth quarter, too, President Bob. Looks like the 30X and the 21X. That's a 30X of Todd Henshaw. Westport native Rick Martin on the front row, this time by looking for the green. 32 laps remain. Al Rodriguez looking him over at the line.
Let's see if Bobby can have a good start. The green was out, but Martin has a problem. Kohler goes around, collects Johnny. Oh, there's trouble. Johnny is down there now. Joey Cirillo are involved with this. I don't know what happened, but Rick Martin didn't have the get-go.
The leader right now, it looks like, is the number 80 of Bobby Tripp.
And this race has a whole new outlook. Bobby Tripp, your 1995 champion and tied for 96, is your new leader. Dad, Johnny Tripp, running second in the field.
Father and son battle for a 100-lap open pro stock competition.
Well, they say this is a family track, and it's no evident now than on the front row. Looking for the green. It's a good start. Valrod likes what he likes. And here, take it away. Bobby gets a good jump, but look at Johnny on the high side. Cute third, Jelinas one, then oh! Kohler goes around in the back straightaway with a little bit of help from Charlie Rose. The 96 of David Hutchins is in the infield. He's got a problem. Kohler was able to get Kohler on his own. It's a dad and son battle up front. It's the 80 of Bobby up front, the 88 of Johnny second. Hutchins gets re-squared. He'll try to rejoin the field. Bobby out front, Johnny looking low, side by side. And look at the 12, Bobby Pellin Jr. moving up to the fifth spot, just dropping right down to six.
What a good run right now for Bobby Pellin. He's all the way up to four. Mark is tripping, Jude, Pellin, and Jelinas, your top five.
Well, that car's going away on Jelinas, and he worked his way quick to the front. He may have used up the tires on that M80.
Bobby Gahan now making a strong run on to the top five. Gahan is now under the Jelinas. Jelinas going to be losing some tire on that car.
That's a tough break for the Scarborough main name all the way down. Great run he had.
Well, unfortunately, it doesn't look like Rick Martin has enough to come through the back of the back. Because up front, Bobby Tripp continues to lead his dad, Johnny Tripp. Jimmy Steele runs third. Bobby Pellin fourth. And Jimmy Rosenfield, fifth. Remember early on, Kevin, Bobby Pellin earlier in the year was having a very, very strong run on one of the 100-mile races where we had an electrical problem or an ignition problem that put his efforts down for the day.
Well, he was very dejected after that race. Came back 2 weeks later and said, I could have won that race. Tonight I'm going to win. And he did just that. He went from green to checker and won his only pro side feature event. He is the 93 Sportsman Champion.
Right now, the man to watch on the move is Bobby Gahan, the number 50. The nesting spot is number 50 to the outside of Rosenfield.
Well, Charlie Rose has some problems on the right front. The right front fender is in the tires. You can see that car smoking. He's losing positions fast. Freddie Estell has got it by. Steve Channing trying to get by. And Mike Roller right behind.
Right now, the 80 and the 88 have to contend with a couple of flat cars. The 96 of Hutchins and the 30 X of Henshaw. Bobby Tripp has got mass Henshaw. Now he's going to fight on Hutchins. Trying to clear the way to give him some running room up front.
Okay, him is flying. He may be one of the fastest cars out of the track now, but he's got about a straightaway between him and your race leader, Bobby Tripp. Less than 30 laps remain. Don't think he can do it without a push. He's praying for one. He needs something.
It is Bobby Tripp out front. He is opening up the lead on his dad, Johnny, in the 88. This reminds me of the years back in the 100 lappers when Vinny had his two cars there with the 11 and the 12, and they were always running 1-2 in the 100 lappers. Well, it's changed a little, and now it's Bobby and Johnny Tripp.
Well, the faces and the names have changed, but the situation hasn't tonight. The black flag is coming out next time by. That's going to be for the number 91 of Charlie Rose, the right front field. On that fender, that could be a problem. What they're trying to do is prevent him from blowing the right front tire and getting into an accident, possibly taking out another car. Look at Bobby Gahan. He's up to front. He's going around the 12 while Bobby's going. He is flying, but he needs a caution. He's only got a handful of laps remaining before the race is over, and he's only got three cars ahead of him. He sits fourth, and now looks at the outside of getting killed with the lap car up. Todd Henshaw is right there.
Yep, Gahan is on the move, but I'll tell you, Bobby Tripp has quite an advantage right now, so it's going to be enough to catch him. Does he have enough to pass?
Well, it's going to be enough to catch Jimmy Kuhn and by him. I don't think he's got enough to catch your front two.
Right now, Charlie Rose and Vinny Moon make their way into the pit. The young leader is still the 80 of Bobby Tripp.
Gahan looking to the high side of Jimmy Kuhn. He's got the outside lead figured out this week. Tonight. He's won here before in the 100 lappers, so it's not a strange place for the New Hampshire native. Looking to the outside of Jimmy Kuhn for that third spot. Gahan is flying. Started way back in the field in 26th spot. He had to start again towards the back. And look at the battle behind him. Larry Gelinas on the inside of Rich Caparco in the 30X with Freddie Estelle right in tall.
Bobby Gahan is now worked his way by Jimmy Kuhn. He is in third. Bobby Gahan is up to third. It's Trippy, Trippy Gahan.
And this
is Jimmy
Kuhn. This time by, just 10 laps remaining. Bobby Tripp has been here before, last year. Does not want a question, does not need a question, as he is absolutely dominant right now. Bobby Tripp all the way out front. Johnny's in second. Gahan up to third spot. Kuhn and the 12 of Bell around with the top five. Gelinas with a great run, run six. It's 44 of Rosenfield, Estelle, Caparco, and the 23 of Channing rounding out the top 10.
What a race is turning out to be. The Trippy boys are still doing a great job, and Bobby Gahan has got to be one of the fastest close stocks on the speedway right now. Jimmy Kuhn has done a dynamite job, and the rookie Bobby Pellin holding on to a top 5. What a good run for the 12 car of Bobby Pellin right now. Your leader is still Bobby Tripp. He has opened up the lead over his dad in the 88. Bobby Tripp
running
into the track all over the place.
Bobby Tripp looking to lap a few more cars before this race is over. But he needs to take it easy. Just 7 laps remain for the Westport Mass native. He's got the 43 of Kenny Kohler in his sights, but he knows he's got the instincts. He's got a big lead over the field. This time by 6 remain for Bobby Tripp in that number 80 car. He's saying, Rip Bird, you may have won the championship, but I'm winning the big money tonight.
Ripley comes up. He's running into some lap traffic. He has to work his way through the lap traffic right now. He has a bunch of cars set up right there. Kenny Kohler gets a little squirrely. That must make Bobby Cox jump a little.
This time by, 2 to go. 2 laps remaining. It's a possible 6-wheel leader, Bobby Tripp in the lead. He's got 5 lap cars in front of him, all battling for position. He's got to spread lightly where he is. 2 laps to go. And oh, we've got a spin. Martin goes around off the second corner. And will this be a repeat of last year? But remember, the lap cars stay where they are.
This should be very interesting. Trippy men are up front. Bobby Gahan is right on the back bumper of Bobby Tripp. We haven't been able to see how Gahan is on the restarts all day. This is going to be a good test. We're going to see what he can do right now. As they come out of four, the green is dropped. Bobby gets the jump on all of them as they go into turns 1 and 2.
Okay, hand right there, Johnny, on the outside. DeHaan in third, side by side. They go this time by. It's the Popsicle 6-2 to go. DeHaan looking underneath Johnny Tripp, a little sideways off the corner. Can't seem to get the advantage. You know, Jenny and Estelle get together off the second corner. A lot of smoke. Looks like the one of Dick Houlihan is also going around. And that's going to once again bring us under another question. And Bobby Tripp will have to do it all over again. Your 95 champion sitting on the pole with just two laps remaining. Can he hold off his dad, Johnny Tripp? Can he hold off Bobby Tripp from the outsider gang looking for a green? Al Rodriguez looking him over. Green is out and we are underway.
Ted Heath this time between the 80 and the 88 as they go into turns one and two, neck and neck. Bobby Gahan trying to knock on Trippy's bumper, but Trippy pulls away. The white flag is waving for Trippy as he takes the whip of man from his dad in the 88.
The last lap, through one and two for the final time down that straightaway. Johnny trying to make a last ditch effort. And look at the jump he gets in the corners. Three and four, here they come. It's a dead heat off the corner, and it's going to be... I can tell you, it's a trip that won. It's a number, it begins with an 8. It's a red car, sponsored by New England Sanitation. Was it dad? Was it son? We're going to have to wait for the official scorer's word.
We went through this earlier in the season with...
Oh, that was too close to call for me, I'll tell you, Kevin. What a run by these two. Oh, you couldn't have a better finish for these two Pro Stock drivers. Look at this. The father and son team are here deciding on who is the victor.
Well, Bobby Tripp dominated towards the end of the race. Johnny Tripp dominated in the beginning. And Johnny got a great, great jump on the last side. And they're pointing to...
There's your winner. And number 80 is Bobby Tripp. What a way to end the season, I'll tell you. These two Trippy men put on quite a show, and the victor is Bobby Tripp.
Well, taking down win number 5. If this had come 3 weeks ago, we might have an important champion. And taking down